Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. This is the continuation to previous video. I will link part 2 in the description box below. So let's get started. Let's see what will be the location of walls at battery limit. Line crossing battery limit will normally be walled and blinded and will consequently require access. Walls will be staggered either side of the walkway to provide maximum clearance and to be provided with extension spindles to handwheel as required. Battery limit line locations are normally an early priority. This picture shows typical single level pipe rack where elevation is to be maintained across battery limit. The walkway will be elevated to clear the largest anticipated line and located to suit the largest wall. Lines with the pipe rack structure steel designed to establish pipe rack design at battery limit and to establish the required headroom clearance over the lower walkway. A simpler method of accessibility to battery limit walls is achieved as shown in the figure, but it is depend upon the pipe rack design and the possible of additional pipe support required for overhead loops. Where lines are to cross battery limit at grade, walls will be brought down for access as indicated in this figure. Let's see what are the flexibility requirements for pipe rack. During the study stage of the pipe rack, preliminary flexibility analysis in coordination with the stress engineer must be take place. Line temperature and insulation thickness must be indicated on the pipe for this purpose. All lines of the extreme temperature, hot or cold, process or utility which travel considerable distance on the rack must be scrutinized for expansion loop consideration. For this, we have to bunching all the high temperature lines. Then we have to determine the line growth for each line by calculating the thermal expansion or contraction. You can also refer our video how to calculate thermal expansion, which you can find in above link. The next step is to determine whether one anchor point will be sufficient. For that, we will try to anchor at the center. After that, based on the flexibility requirement, we will rearrange the lines. Like here you can see, we have rearranged the lines. Earlier it was 10 inch, 8 inch and then 6 inch. Now it is 6 inch, 8 inch and 10 inch. Having the hottest and the largest diameter line outside, which is required the more flexibility and more loop. The expansion loop nest can now be indicated by the stress engineer related to the anchor point in the brace bay in a clear convenient location. The loop will generally rise to the established takeoff level. An important aspect of the rack piping design is strategic location of the line stop or anchor and guides to control the thermal expansion of piping. Directional line stop also help to distribute expansion forces and support friction loads. Pipe expansion loop may be required for long length of pipe rack piping, especially in the elevated temperature services. Let's see what are the pipe rack loadings are required for consideration of pipe rack design. The first one is sustained load, which is also called dead load. It is nothing but the weight of the pipe, wall and insulation. The next one is thermal load. It is the load of thermal expansion of pipe and reaction force by internal pressure and expansion bellows. The next one is dynamic load. It is load by the vibration of the pipe or by the wind or earthquake. And the last one is sustained load, which is also called live load, liquid load of hydrostatic pressure test. Let's move to our last topic, pipe rack piping economy. The economy in the pipe rack piping basically depend on the length of the lines arranged on rack. Fitting, walls and instrument are relatively few in pipe rack compared to pipe length. This sketch shows critical dimension like A, B, C, D, E, which will influence piping cost from pipe rack piping layout point of view. These dimensions depend upon the overall piping plan layout and should be carefully considered when the plot is developed. Let's see what is dimension A. Dimension A is the total length of pipe rack and is governed by number and size of equipment, structure and building arranged along both sides of the pipe rack. On an average, about 10 feet of the rack length is required per process equipment, like exchanger, drum, tower, unhoused compressor, etc. A control room located along the rack will increase the pipe rack piping cost because all the line must pass by without really being associated with the relatively long control room. To shorten pipe rack length, various methods are applied like equipment in pairs, stack exchanger, exchangers under elevated drum, drum or exchanger supported on tower with a common platform, drum supported on exchangers, process equipment located under the rack, etc. These arrangements not only shorten the process interconnection equipment directly, but also shorten those lines which pass through this area and utility headers serving this area. Dimension B should be carefully selected to minimize the pipe length between the pipe rack and process equipment and pipe length interconnected equipment on opposite side of the pipe rack. Dimension C is normally 6 to 7 feet. Dimension D and E should be decided based on what is minimum necessary to reduce the vertical piping length. For economical design of pipe rack structure, an evaluation by a structure expert should be done. This expert can determine whether the steel or concrete or a combination of two is the most desirable choice and what span and spacing will be give the most economical arrangement. So guys, please do like, share, comment, subscribe to our channel and follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn. And if you want us to prepare a video on some certain topic, let us know in the comment section. And please don't forget to press the bell icon to get the all notification. Thank you.